and realized, okay, I could play a role here. Let's start learning how to fight properly.
Oh yeah, so I
And
want to get to that.
yeah,
Where,
so and
where'd
then
you
I,
learn how to fight? Was that
well,
with
just
him or?
basically, yeah, some with Brack. My older brother Paul was a good fighter, and even my younger brother Trevor, they were good fighters in hockey and stuff. So Paul was inspiring to me. Paul was a really good, strong, one-dimensional fighter. He'd grab you and pull you, and then just beat on you, right? He was like old school Tony Twist, Bobby
Yeah.
Probert. But I knew that I couldn't just fight like that because I wasn't, you know, laws of physics don't allow me to fight, you know, a guy like, if I was going to fight Peter Orel, which is 6'7", 285 pounds, physics and analytics tell you that I'm going to lose 90% of the time.
Right.
So I had to
Reach,
learn
right.
how to develop a style, how to fight. So what I did was, there's a company out of Massachusetts called Drop the Gloves, really passionate about fighting. I got a hold of them, and they used to have VHSs of all the fighters in the NHL. So I got Darren Langdon, I got everybody. And I started watching all the fighters, and I said, and I love Darren Langdon was one of the best fighters of all time. Ask any fighter, maybe the media will never tell you this, but ask any fighter, they'll always tell you Darren Langdon's up there as top three ever in the world.
Jesus
And Darren
Christ.
Langdon, he was like from Deer Lake, Newfoundland, just a good down-to-earth guy.
Yeah.
I don't think he can even bench press 175 pounds. That's
No
apparently
way.
the word was, yeah. But he had a way about him where he knew geometry, he knew structure, he knew physics.
Physics.
He just knew how to push and pull, and then get guys just teetering off their edges a little bit while he was doing the opposite. So basically what he was doing a style where he was like, he was counter punching. So if a guy was coming in, he was basically using his energy to his advantage.
Wow.
And
Yeah,
then I
I
took,
got
so
you.
and then I took Ty Domi and developed a cyclone. So he got guys in the swing. So how is this little guy beating guys 6'4", 6'5", 6'6", 6'7", 6'8"? So then I started to study. I studied everything about Ty, everything about Darren, then I put the combination together. Then Aaron Downey was born.
This is crazy.
That's
This is
how it
like
is. So,
so.
and then I needed to learn how to develop a punch. So actually, I was a righty growing up as a kid, and then I did become a lefty because I used to just practice my left everywhere I went. If I was driving my truck down the road, I'd just sit here and go
No way.
thousands and thousands of times a day, planting potatoes and spraying with my Uncle Eddie. I'd be just sitting there in the back of the planter, just throwing punches all day long while I was doing sit-ups, push-ups, running out, grabbing rocks, coming back to the planter, putting on a check mark right in the back of the planter on the dust. Okay, there's 150, there's 50 and 50. And by the end of the day, I had hundreds and hundreds of sit-ups and push-ups and punches.
This is insane to
So
me.
you just train yourself. Like anything else in life, you just, like the development of a baby, you
Yeah, you're
know?
saying you train yourself, but as an outsider,
Yeah.
we think that you just were good at fighting and became an NHL player based
I
on
was
that
scared
fact. But
shitless. I was scared shitless. I
you
didn't want to
fucking
fight.
worked
I
at
didn't
it.
want to fight. I wasn't a fighter growing up. I remember, so the first time I was playing for the Grand Valley Harvesters, Junior C, and I made the team on just a guy that was going to go out and run around. Eventually, when you run around enough and you start playing in Junior C, Junior B, you know what's going to happen. You run around enough, someone's going to come out and you're going to have to answer the bell.
Right.
So I remember one night in Wingham, I answered the bell, fought one of their defense. I wish I could remember his name. It'd be nice to give him a shout out because he actually changed my life. I was mad. I got really, really mad in the fight, and I remember just getting mad and getting beat up. And I was like, okay, so I want to sit down on the drawing board. Why did I get beat up there? Because I couldn't see.
Right.
Because when you're mad, you're not able to see.
No, no.
So whenever you're in the moment,
And that's
enjoying
where the
it,
mindfulness training
that's
comes
it.
from,
So
right?
it's like, yeah. So it's yeah. There it is. There I got my degree in, you know, strategic planning and visualization, and then different books I read over the years, different teachers I read over the years about being present and learning how to breathe properly. It was just taught me how to see the punches coming. And then I was able to take that combination of Darren Lang and Ty Domi, and then that's the character of Aaron Downey began, and then I went on a run. And not saying I won all the fights, but as long as you showed up for the majority of them, and then your majority overweighed the ones that you lost, then you have a career.
The bull race or bull race, I
Yeah.
forget his name. That
Yeah,
was the
just
most incredible thing I've ever seen.
This should be very good. They better go quick or the linesman's gonna jump in. That's what he's saying to him. He's measuring, and here we go. Downey.
That was no disrespect. Jesse did a good job. You know what? I could just tell you this truth straight up today. Jesse had the punch. Everybody said that Jesse messed up, but actually no, he had it right. There should have been someone there, but I made the illusion. The punch was called the illusion. I worked at the illusion for summer after summer, and I learned how to do the illusion. And I was using the illusion in the American League, and nobody could figure the illusion out. I was hitting guys left, right, and center with the illusion.
So what is
So
the
you see
illusion?
what Kevin Bieksa did. He did call the Superman punch.
Yes.
But before there even was a Superman punch, all my fights, I wouldn't even grab on right off the bat. If I was fighting a bigger guy, I hit them with the illusion.
What does that mean?
The illusion. Well, I just made it because what it is, no matter what, if you have a split second, even if you have a premeditated fight, whenever you drop the gloves, two guys drop the gloves and they stare each other down.
Yeah.
Usually you give a, you only have about 2.5 seconds max to figure out what he's going to do.
Okay.
So it's like, bang, you got to rely on your instincts. Mm-hmm. But if I'm, what I try to do is make them have a picture of what I'm going to do. And then I change the picture, but they still have the picture in their mind. Now there's not enough time.
Wow.
There's not enough time for them to recover, to kind of figure out, okay, this is all gone wrong. Where is he?
Yeah.
So basically if I paint a picture as a righty, all of a sudden if I close the gap now, become a lefty, I'm over here.
Oh, so you switch to southpaw.
So I switch to southpaw. So it doesn't matter. I can even show up as southpaw, but then I can switch it back.
Wow.
So it's just two strips of body. So basically what I'm doing is I'm sending a message to his subconscious mind right off the bat. And subconscious mind believes all things. So it's bang. So it's pretty deep. It's tensive. It's like some magic. It's what the magicians and everyone use. Hope I'm not giving one secret away. So quick example. So if I just show my hand right here.
Right.
Show this hand here. If I show right off the bat, I'm going to be ready.
Right.
Put
this in front of your eyes. I'm already defense here.
If I put this in front of your eyes, bring this punch back behind here. And now, right when you get ready to throw, I'm on this side.
Jesus.
Just like that. Now you come over here. I'm already loaded. So when you come through with this punch,
yeah,
you miss me. Now you're here. Guess what?
Dead.
Now I can take here. But if I was over here, squared up this way,
yeah,
watch. Bully Reese was coming here. He would have got me.
So you switched to the last second.
I was over here.
And you were just,
bang.
That's death. You can't do anything. I'm here. My energy's gone.
It worked for a long time, but I sold my soul.
By doing stuff like this?
Darcy Hordachuk asked me one year, we were out in England, and during a lockout, and he asked me, how are you doing those punches? And he had a business deal for me. So I basically went out there and trained him how to do those punches.
Business.
And then I showed him, he gave me this business deal on some property out in Arizona, and then, I went signed in St. Louis, and the illusion just wasn't working for him anymore. Jody Shelley called me in my bluff one night, and he ended up catching me pretty good there. And actually, he gave me a concussion. And I remember Dougie Waite actually had to carry me out there. Dougie Waite said to me, you okay? And I just remember Dougie just being at my aid. But anyways, that doesn't really matter. It's all part of it all. It was a great time. Darcy's a good guy, good family. But anyways, I ended up having to reinvent myself, come up with another punch. So you continue to invent, but you can only ride out something so long. So I rode out the illusion as long as I could, and then you had to figure another way. And then guys would start doing that. I'm not saying I'm taking the credit for the Superman punch, but if you're someone that studies videos like I did, and you're someone that was in the game, then you'd probably think, okay, how can we do this? What was he doing? How was it so successful for you?
Yeah. So you said you were a high school dropout, but this is like... This is a genius.
Two times.
You saw a lane and an opportunity where not a lot of guys going to the National Hockey League are taking advantage of. And you studied and you perfected and you worked your ass off to become this position that's needed in the National Hockey League.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's ingenious, really.
I think now the biggest thing too now, which is probably where I help more people out now, is just the mental part of it all, really. I had a degree basically of visualization and strategic planning so I could be mentally strong, because whenever you bounce around from team to team, or you get beat up, get your feelings hurt, you got to learn how to recover right off the bat, right? You got to learn how to be in that same steadfast, that same positive energy, because that gives you the energy to continue to perform the role.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't have a plan for that, then that's why people fail. And that's why people succumb to the pressures, you know, of maybe sign $10 million and they got to get 75 points a year. And so say they get 75 points in the regular season, but now can you do it during the playoffs? So those kind of pressures, which you're seeing now with some players in different teams, that they don't have the mental strength to perform yet. Some have to go through the experience of failure.
Mm-hmm.
And then some have it built into the program right off the bat. Very few do right now, but now we're starting to kind of understand now, you know, like everybody trains, you know that. Everybody does. Everyone trains explosive. Everyone does yoga and everyone's trying to learn how to be mindful. That's the next step.
Actually, I know a great guy named Matt Nickel.
Yeah, Matty's a good guy. Trains. I know Matt.
You know Matt? Well. Yeah, okay. So I ran this thing. I was on the training staff for something called the BioSteel All-Canadian Basketball Games.
Yeah.
And I had the pleasure of having dinner with Matt one night.
Super intelligent.
Very smart.
And he's awesome what he does. He's trained a lot of great players over the years.
Yeah, Sagan, McDavid. Yeah.
Mark
crazy.
Bell, he's trained.
Mark Bell, I haven't heard that name in a while.
Mark Bell had a great career. He's one of my good best friends. And
was he at that camp?
Yeah. Okay.
Speaking of,
so. I doubt he was.
Speaking of the pitcher.
Oh shit, let me see this.
The pitcher.
No way. Me and Brad Nassau were in that camp.
Oh, okay.
Brad lives in Texas.
I think Mark Bell.
I gotta get my glasses. Can I get up?
Of course. I'm the one doing something different in the middle with the stupid pose. I'm doing this stupid pose here.
That is you.
Yeah.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah.
Stand out.